Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Last Sunday, SpaceX successfully launched their 116th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of NG23.
One, engine full power, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Cygnus.
The booster which launched this mission, B1094, then landed successfully for the fourth time on the landing pad at Landing Zone 2.
Final burn that this booster will see before landing.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
Later in the week, on Thursday, SpaceX successfully launched their 117th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1061.
One. Liftoff.
The booster which launched this mission, B1092, then landed successfully for the seventh time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions. The following day, SpaceX successfully launched their 118th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1712.
One, ignition, and liftoff of Falcon 9. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1088, then landed successfully for the 10th time on the drone ship, Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
Then this morning, SpaceX successfully launched their 119th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1027.
One, engines full power, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go SpaceX.
The booster which launched this mission, B1085, then landed successfully for the 11th time on the drone ship, a shortfall of gravitas.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
Stage 2 FTL.
This coming week, we can hopefully expect to see a handful of Falcon launches. The first of these, the NROLL 48 mission, is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 22nd at 6:23 PM UTC or 2:23 PM EDT. The following day, and we should see another customer mission launch. The IMAP and others mission is currently scheduled for Tuesday 23rd at 12:32 PM UTC or 8:32 AM EDT. A couple of days after that, and we should see a Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 1711 mission is currently scheduled for Thursday 25th at 2:57 AM UTC or Wednesday 24th at 10:57 PM EDT. Just a matter of hours after that, and we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 1015 mission is currently scheduled for Thursday 25th at 9:36 AM UTC or 5:36 AM EDT. Heading to Boca Chica, there was recently an Orbital Pad 2 water deluge test at Starbase. I wanted to share this cool aerial shot of the massive Pad 2 launch mount. The foundation work for the new Gigabay has been continuing in the production yard. Work on the apartment building at Starbase has been continuing. The mystery tank we saw in the last video was seen moving around recently. The B18.1 test tank was seen undergoing a lot of testing recently. During the 10th test, it sprung a possibly intentional leak. Apparently, SpaceX will have a ship they are calling You'll Thank Me Later that will transport vehicles from Starbase to Florida. In response to a question about a new drone ship, Elon Musk said warship to transport spaceship from Starbase to Cape Canaveral. Related to this, SpaceX's VP of Launch, Kiko Donchev, gave some information about how the vehicles will be transported. He said, while this would certainly look pretty rad, we are planning to break over both the booster and ship to the horizontal position to transit from Starbase to the Cape. Initial deliveries are a single booster or ship per trip, with the plan to move multiple vehicles per transit sooner than later. There's been some information posted about NASA believing the lunar Starship may be many years late. This article says NASA's safety advisors say they doubt the lunar lander version of SpaceX's Starship will be ready to support the Artemis 3 mission as planned in 2027. With the Booster 15 static fire recently, SpaceX are continuing to prepare for Starship Flight 11 with Ship 38 testing soon. They posted some pictures of Starship 38 rolling to the launch site and on the pad and said Starship moved to the pad at Starbase for pre-flight testing. SpaceX attempted and aborted a couple of rounds of Ship 38 testing recently. With Starship 38 rolled out for testing, we could see the static fire within a couple of days as SpaceX has dates on the Cameron County website. The possible closures are currently scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 22nd and Tuesday 23rd. As always, I have to say thanks to both Cesar Garcia and Jack Beyer for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.